Hello, I'm TB. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how to use the cue points. I just had recently a request from someone asking about this feature, and I decided to do a video tutorial because this will simplify things for you to understand. So the Ultimate Video Player has a feature that allows to call JavaScript functions, any type of JavaScript function, at specified cue points on the playlist play. I'm sorry, on the video player timeline. So let's say, for example, if you want maybe at second 20 to open, I don't know, a new page or call any JavaScript function. In this example, I will show you how to use the API of the player to play another video from the playlist when the time arrive at a certain point on the playback timeline. So we have here two functions. These are added in Gutenberg with the classical editor, and it seems that doesn't. Anyway, this is how it's added. We have a script here, and we have two function. Go to video 2 and go to video 3. This function are calling the video API, the play video method, which accept a parameter. In this case, it's 1 and 2. So this is the method here from the API. You can read all the methods if you like, but this is the method that we need, and this is playing a video based on the video ID on this parameter, and it's starting from 0. So for example, this is video 0, this is video 1, this is video 2. So this is why play video 2, you see here play video 1. Okay, with the short code, I'm adding the player in the play in the page in the post in this case. And now let's go to the playlist manager and select the first video and add the cue points. To add the cue points, go down here and click on add cue point. I will call it 1. In this case, it can be any name. Start time, I will start at second 20. So the format has to be hours, minutes, and seconds. It is explained here in the tooltip. And now to call the JavaScript function, if you remember, we called it, go to video 2. It's very important here to just add the function name and the parentheses. Do not try to add parameters or something else, because it will not work. It will break the code. So just add the function name, and this will run on second 20. And we'll add another one at second 30, and we'll call it go to video 3. Update the playlist. And now this is the player. This is the first video. So we have a self-hosted video and two YouTube videos. So at second 20, the player will start playing the YouTube video 1, and at second 14, it will play the YouTube video 2. So let's play this. Let's skip a bit. So 20, it will go to the second video. Okay, let's go back, and now let's scroll a bit to almost second 14. As you can see, now it's playing the second YouTube video here. Now, right now, the cue points are set to always reset themselves. So if the video 1 starts again, if it gets to second 20, it will do the same thing again. It will play the first video, and if it gets to second 14, it will play the second video, and so forth. So basically, the cue points are resetted every time the video that contains the cue points it's starting playing again. To avoid this thing, in the general settings, select the preset that you are using. In this case, I'm using my preset. And there is an option here, execute cue points only once. Set it to yes. And what this does, it will only execute the cue point once. What after that is finished, it will not execute it again. Okay, update the preset. And now if I refresh it, so now if I play the video, it will run the first cue point. It will go to the second video. And now if you go again to this place, since the cue point was executed, it will not execute it again. So now let's go to the second one. Second 14. It will go to the second video. And now if I go to either the first one, it will not execute it anymore. And now to the second one, to skip it. So this is how the cue points it used in related to the player API. This is just one example. The possibilities are endless. So yeah, I hope you will find this video useful. And this is indeed a great feature. Thank you for watching.